Hey everyone, welcome to Podcasting and Technical Communication. Today I will clarify what podcasts are, how they work, and the process for creating an online presence for your podcast that can be shared across any device. To begin, podcasts are not radio. They are pre-recorded audio made available through digital download. With this, podcasts are available on any device through a range of apps and services. Typically, they are used to share recorded interviews, narrative content, and even company communications. For example, the gym I worked for in Arizona created a public podcast to interview a member of the month, then shared that with members across our 14 locations. This exemplifies the value of podcasting within the field of technical communication and business. Most importantly, podcasts are sent to an RSS feed that listeners can subscribe to. In the past, I've attempted to start podcasting with friends, but we never continued past the initial recording because we did not understand how to set up this RSS feed. For this screencast, I'll show you how to create an RSS feed, upload a podcast to the feed, and submit that feed to a podcast database. You'll need a SoundCloud account, your podcast audio file, and a 1400 by 1400 pixel logo for your podcast. Make sure you have the files saved on your computer where you can find them easily. So let's get started. Here we are inside SoundCloud. To begin, you need to set up your RSS feed, so come over to this menu, then drop down to Settings. Now, click on Content to bring up your RSS information. You'll need this RSS URL throughout the rest of this process, so copy and paste it into a document. I've already done this to help speed up the video, but as you can see, I also have other necessary information, such as this custom feed title, which I'll paste into this box. This will be your podcast title, so use any title you'd like here. Then I'll quickly punch in my name here. This is totally optional. Next, drop down the page to upload defaults. Check both boxes so as you upload your podcast episodes, new podcasts are automatically placed in your RSS feed. Click Save Changes, then navigate to your name here at the top of the page and click Profile. Here, you'll edit your profile information that will appear in the podcast feed. Click on Edit, then Update Image. Select the 1400 by 1400 pixel image you chose earlier. This will be your podcast logo seen across every device. I've created this image here, then I'll copy and paste some basic information into these fields. You can enter whatever you'd like here, just know that it may appear on your podcast feed. Lastly, add a link to your RSS feed here. This way, if someone pulls up your SoundCloud profile, they can quickly subscribe to the RSS feed. I'll type in technology, assignment, podcast, then click Save Changes. Now that your basic information is complete, click on Upload at the top of your page to upload your first episode's audio. Choose a file to upload and find your audio file on your PC. The audio I'm using is a sample audio I found online, so I need to give it a specific title with artist credit. For the genre, I'll pick learning. Then paste this description with my necessary fair use information into this field. Once you've filled out your desired information, click Save. That's all we need to do in SoundCloud. Our last step is submission. You can submit your RSS feed to iTunes and other internet radio companies, but many, such as iTunes, require a sort of application and acceptance process before your podcast is available publicly. Luckily, the podcast app PocketCasts that I already use regularly on my phone does not require this type of application process. So, open a new tab and navigate to PocketCasts.com/submit. Once that loads, copy and paste your RSS feed into the submission field. Then click Submit. It may take a few minutes for this to complete, but when you're done, a screen like this will appear. I've done this earlier while testing this process, so the site tells me my feed has already been submitted. That's just fine. Either way, PocketCasts will give you the shareable link to post online or open in a separate device. When I open the link on my phone, I'm taken to this site, showing my podcast and information. Now I can open this in my PocketCasts app and see my podcast feed here in the app. From this page, I can subscribe to the feed, and it appears up here in my PocketCasts homepage, along with my other podcast subscriptions. By clicking on my podcast, I am shown a list of podcast episodes available to download and listen to. And there you have it, a simple process to create and share your podcast with friends, family, employees, and coworkers.